Lord, we adore you. Would you just like to lift your voices this resurrection morning and just say, Lord, we thank you. Thank you that you went to the cross. Thank you that you took my place. Thank you that you paid my debts. Thank you that you died for me. Thank you that you resurrected. Death could not hold you captive. You rose again. Hallelujah. Lord, we worship you this morning. Would somebody just like to worship God this morning? Show some gratitude for the work that he did on the cross and on our behalf. Lord, we're just grateful to you. Lord, we thank you this morning. Lord, we bless your holy name. Lord, we worship. We just worship. We just worship you. We just worship you. We just worship you. You deserve all worship. You deserve all honor. You deserve all adoration. We just bless you this morning. We just honor you this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you for the cross, Lord Jesus. Thank you for the price you paid, bearing all my sin and shame. In love you came and gave amazing grace. Thank you for this love, Lord. Thank you. Of hate. Lord, we worship you this morning. Thank you that you shed your blood on the cross. Thank you that you rose again from the dead. And today you hold the keys of hell and of hate and of hates. You have the password. You hold the access code. Lord, we worship you. Oh, we adore you. Today you gave grace to us. You brought healing on that cross. 1 Peter 2:24 says, by your stripes we were healed. Lord, you brought deliverance. The Bible says, for this purpose was the Son of God manifested, to destroy the works of the enemy. Oh, we worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We exalt you, Lord. This day of resurrection, this day of newness, can be likened to Passover. When the blood of the lambs was put upon the doorpost, the blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ, has been shed for us. And the Bible says, because of the sprinkling of the blood, there is the sprinkling of the blood. In this place this morning, we plead the blood of Jesus. And we connect to the sprinkling of the blood. Because we are blood bought. The Bible says we have been bought with a price. That price is the blood of Jesus that was shed for us on the cross of Calvary. And the Bible says that on the third day he rose again from the dead. Thank you, because you rose from the dead. Romans 8:11 says that the spirit that raised Jesus from the dead lives in you. That same spirit will quicken your mortal bodies also. Today we connect to the quickening of bodies. The quickening of the mortal bodies by the reason of the resurrection power. By the reason of the Spirit of God. Colossians chapter 2 says that you made a public show of them, triumphing over them in it. And Colossians 2:14 says, blotting out every handwriting of ordinances that was against us, he nailed it to the cross. He nailed it to the cross. He nailed it to the cross. The one who has the keys of hell and of hate. The same one says in Matthew 18:18. He says, I give you the keys. I give you the keys of the kingdom. I give you the keys. That whatever you permit is permitted. And whatever you disallow is disallowed.
Amen.
And so this morning in this place, on this resurrection morning, I stand to disallow everything that the Lord has not planned for your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Everything that the Lord has not planted in your life is disallowed. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I disallow sicknesses. In the name of Jesus, I disallow depression and anxiety and fear and paranoia and every mental health challenge. I disallow. In the name of Jesus, I disallow lack. In the name of Jesus, I disallow barrenness. In the name of Jesus, I disallow trouble. I speak peace. In the name of Jesus, the Bible says in Isaiah 53 that the chastisement of our peace was upon him. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. That was a divine exchange, a occurred, and the chastisement of our peace was upon him, so that we might have peace. I speak peace into your life, into your bodies, into your families, into your minds, in the name of Jesus. Receive that peace of God that passes all understanding, in the name of Jesus. In every circumstance of your life, receive that peace of God that passes all understanding, in the name of Jesus. In your families, in your relationships, in your marriages, in your places of work, in our town, in our church, we receive the peace of God that passes all understanding. We receive the peace of God in the name of Jesus. Colossians 2:14 says, the New Living Translation says, that he canceled all your legal indebtedness. He canceled all your legal indebtedness. Whatever you owe physically, whatever you owe spiritually, whatever legal ground that the enemy has held on to, to afflict you or to operate in your life, that scripture says he canceled all your legal indebtedness. He nailed it to the cross. And when he was going to yield up the ghost, the Bible says that he said, it is finished. It's all paid for. It's all paid for. Amen. All your debts are paid. All your debts are paid. All your debts are paid. He took your shame. That you will not be ashamed. He was a substitute for you. He was a substitute for me. He will exchange. He exchanged your weaknesses for strengths. He exchanged that rejection for acceptance. He exchanged that exclusion for inclusion. He exchanged that sickness for health. Would you just believe this morning that the resurrection power can take care of that sickness and that disease? It says, if that spirit, the spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, lives in you, that same spirit shall quicken, give life to your mortal body. He exchanged your sorrow for gladness. He exchanged bondage for freedom, for liberty, for deliverance. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Everything that stood hostile to you, he nailed to the cross. 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 Everything that stood in opposition to you, he nailed to the cross. Every handwriting of ordinances that was against you, he nailed to the cross. Every legal indebtedness, he nailed to the cross. Every debt owed, he nailed to the cross. Every legal ground that the enemy is holding on to, he's putting guilt on you, he's putting shame on you, he nailed to the cross. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Every failure, he nailed to the cross. Every barrenness, he nailed to the cross. Every unfruitfulness, he nailed to the cross. Every stagnancy, he nailed to the cross. Every every oppression, every terror, he nailed to the cross. This morning you have colored sheets on your bulletin. I'd like you to write that thing that you want nailed to the cross. What is that thing? You want there to be a manifestation of the nailing to the cross of that thing. Write it on that sheet. Bring it to that cross and glue it there. When you finish putting it on that cross and gluing it there, you want to come before this altar and pick a positive substitute for what you have nailed on that cross. It's a prophetic action I want you to do this morning. And I want you to believe that as you are physically putting that thing, sticking it on that poor representation of the cross, that heaven is responding to you. And as you are picking a positive substitute from this altar this morning, that heaven is responding to you. And that is what is going to happen. In the name of Jesus, we give you praise. Hallelujah. Don't wait for anyone. It's between you and God. You're going to take a bold step. You're going to do something you've never done before. Write that thing that you want an end to today. Put it on that cross. Stick it on that poor representation of the cross that is standing there. Come to this altar and pick something. If what you need is not there. If what you need is not there. Can somebody, Sylvester, can you give me yellow stickers or post-its? If what you need is not there, we're going to write it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the cross, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you for You went down to the grave. And then the voice rang out. And he said, lift up your heads, O ye gates. Be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors. And the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates. Even lift them up, ye everlasting doors. And the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. And the earthquake came, and everywhere was shaken, and the stone rolled back, and up from the grave you went, and you rose again. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! You became the Lord of all.
Amen.
Today you are seated at the right hand of the Father.
Hallelujah.
The one who has a name that is highly exalted.
Amen.
Above every other name.
Amen.
Your word says that your name, every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Amen.
To the glory of God the Father.
Hallelujah.
This morning I pray for your children. And I pray regarding every one of those things that have been dropped at the cross. Lord, we're asking for the manifestation of the exchange that you have already done.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That those things that have been locked up today, oh God, that they would resurrect.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Those things that have been locked behind the everlasting doors. Those health situations, that colon disorder, that depression, that cancer, that barrenness, that failure, that joblessness, that stagnancy, going round and round in circles, that addiction, the power is broken.
Amen.
Because Jesus is alive.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, you are made the scapegoat. And so we put a stop to every scapegoating happening in the lives of your people. In the name of Jesus. Hebrews 9:11 says you are the final scapegoat. The final sacrifice. There is no need for any more sacrifice. Lord, we put a stop to every scapegoating. In the name of Jesus, the Jerusalem Bible says, he overrode, that is Colossians 2:14. He says, he overrode the law and nailed it to the cross and gave us grace. Grace is that supernatural help in helpless situations. That supernatural assistance that we receive. This morning, Lord, we receive grace.
Amen.
We receive grace in every situation.
Amen.
We receive grace in every circumstance.
Amen.
We receive grace, oh God. We receive grace in the place of our health. We receive grace in our families. We receive grace in the work of our hands. We receive grace in everything, oh God. We receive grace. We walk by grace. We walk in grace. We walk in grace. Today we cease in our labor and we walk in grace. We begin to ride on the wings of grace. We begin to ride on the wings of grace. We begin to ride on the wings of grace. The struggles are ended. In the name of Jesus, Lord, your peace that passes all understanding keeps our hearts. No matter what is happening, oh God, your peace that passes all understanding keeps our hearts. In the name of Jesus, today is a day of freedom. Today is a day of freedom. Today is a day of salvation. Today is a day of salvation. We receive freedom. We receive salvation. Oh God, we receive freedom in every department of our life. We receive salvation. We receive salvation. We receive salvation in every department of our lives. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. We receive resurrection in every dead area. Everything that is dead against the will and the counsel of God. We receive resurrection in the name of Jesus. Death could not hold you captive. You rose again. Hallelujah. You rose again. He's alive. Jesus is alive. Because he's alive, we can face tomorrow. Because he's alive, we continue to live. We have hope. We have hope eternal because it's alive. We have hope of our resurrection because it's alive. Father Lord, we give you praise. We worship you. Thank you for your presence and your power in this place this morning. Thank you because for everyone that has taken this little exercise seriously and have put those things on the cross, they are finished with. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you because it's a new dawn. It's the beginning of new things. It's a new dawn. Like resurrection morning was a new dawn. It is a new dawn. In the name of Jesus, the beginning of new things. In our lives, in our walk with you. In our relationship with you. In our relationship with men. In all that we do, we give you praise. We worship you. Hallelujah, Lord. Blessed be your name, O God. Hallelujah, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.